मैं भी नहीं रोक पाया। वाइट प्रदेश के गणराज्य में साहस था, शौर्य था, न था उनमें कुछ तो वह थी एकता। अलक्षेंद्र के पथ पर मस्तक बिछा दिए पर राष्ट्र की वेदी पर अपने अहंकार को समर्पित नहीं किया। रुजकान व मद्रक के मार्ग व कठों की भूमि रक्त से नहा उठी और खोपड़ियों को अपनी ठोकर में ठुकराता अलक्षेंद्र आगे बढ़ गया। कोई नहीं था जो उसका मार्ग रोकता।
नमस्ते, your sound is not coming.
Yes sir, I was muted.
Yeah, okay, ask me. You had some doubts, right?
Yes sir.
Good
sir, I did not understand the meaning of shorda.
You tell the sentence.
प्रदिष्टे का राज्यों में सहजता, शौर्यता, नताओं कुछ तो बात एकता।
How did you pronounce it? शौर्यता।
Yes sir.
शौर्यता is courage, energy, शूर्यम, शौर्यम, शौर्यम, शौर्यम is the voracious courage. With the शौर्यम only one can fight with somebody else. Dhirata is courage, but dhirata in action is called shauryam. You take weapon and we call it as rage, no? Rage the war, that is called shauryata. Every soldier should be shura, veera shura parakrami. Veera, great, courageous. Shura, who will take weapon and then go ahead, is called Shura. Yeah.
Then sir, in the beginning of the video, he was telling a sentence, but that sentence was not complete. So only Rok Paya was, I can only hear Rok
that,
Paya.
See, it doesn't matter where do you start, where do you end. It only want me, no, I want you to have that spirit. And it also tells you, you know what is the message?
Yes, sir.
What is the message?
So he is telling about Alexander and warning them about.
How?
Sir, by giving them courage and telling that they should always, they should awaken these. The sleeping
country. How he faced Alexander and then stopped Alexander invading India is the question.
By building strong people.
Yeah, he made India united. In our history class, normally what is taught in the classroom, we learn Britishers united India. India became one after Britishers came because it was under one rule. This is much before that. That time itself he started telling all of us should join together so that Alexander cannot invade India. And he went to each and every king. He started telling the Magadha king, you are the head of the nation, great man, great king. But when head gets a problem, definitely if head is aching, what you will do? We will hold our hand and stop, right? So hand is another small country. The whole India is our body. Each part by part is one country. Small states. So when we have headache, definitely with hand only we have to hold. So don't think that Magadha is independent. Magadha needs help of other small states, like hand needs help for the head. When you fall, head will not to get a damage, because the hand will go first and then put your hand down. They don't even mind. They're destroying themselves to safeguard your head. And then he will go to the smaller states, like which are the hands which he explained. He will tell them, head already agreed that they are with all of us. So you should also join the head. So he went to each and every Rajas around. And that is the spirit he is talking there. Uniting India. Concept was not British's. We learn something in history, but we must learn how it happened much before that. How this evolution happened. The thought process of Bharat as a single nation. Yeah. So it doesn't matter where do you start. It only talks about a concept. The concept should be in you, so that when you present it becomes beautiful. Okay.
Sir, here he is telling that some of these parts in one, it's not clear for me, so I left the space over there.
You read or you tell that portion whatever fashion you want. I will correct it.
Alexandre ke patthar, the space is there. Raj ke vidhi par apni ahangar ko samarpit nahi kiya.
Yeah. Alexander ke patthar nahi, path par. When
yes,
the path which he takes. How are you listening to YouTube? Do you know how to reduce the speed and then listen?
Yes sir, that's how I did.
Okay, so it is not a pathar, padpar. Padpar means the path which he goes. His ego took him along. He never bothered about the path. That must be the concept. Again, tell me that path word sentence again.
Alakshantra ke path par, Raj ke vedi par, apne ahankar ko samarpit nahi kiya.
So nowhere he wanted to submit himself, telling that no, I am not want to get into this. He was always ready for this fight. He prepared himself for this. That's what it shows. Yeah.
The meaning of this sentence I do not understand, sir. Na mastago aur shatko ke bhumi ke veeron ko jinhone Alexandre ke Bharat mein rehte hi Alexandre ke virudh vidroh kiya.
Mastak means brain, buddhi. No brain went against the Alexander. The invasion of Alexander was coming. Nobody is thinking about it. No mastak is thinking about it. Means nobody is in this thought process at all. He has not entered. So we should start thinking about he is going to come, because he has invaded other nations. So definitely he will come to India. That thought process we should have before he comes. Read again.
Na mastago aur shargo ke bhumi hero ko jinhone Alexandre ke Bharat mein rehte hi Alexandre ke virudh vidroh kiya.
Yeah. Against him, how to fight? Against him, how to move? Nobody thought about it.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, continue. You just keep listening. Pallavi, don't make a disturbance when the discussions happens. You should join there, understand the context. If you have some doubts, you can ask. Yeah.
This sentence, Durbhagya hi tha, is dhara ka sthano par akraman karne ki akrantao ka saath aam vidhav aur anya shashko ke diya.
cut the sentence in the first part and the next part. I will tell you that. A nirbhagya ehe. What is nirbhagya? What is unfortunate?
Is dhara ka santano par.
Yeah, in this.
Akraman karne ke liye.
In this sequence of things which is happening, to go against him, akraman karne ke liye, is dhara, the sequence. What he is doing is a sequence of oppression. In that, next part. Yeah, everybody started giving support to them actually. And he has great shastra, weapons with him. Astra shastram. He is equipped with all this. And in his flow, that supported him. So indirectly it says, we don't have that sort of a equipment with us. We don't have that sort of power with us. But still we can win, not independently, united. That is the essence of that sentence. He wanted to say that Alexander is not a normal person, like other king in the country. He has got a great series of weapons with him and he is sequentially winning all the places. You are muted.
This sentence. Apne hi baato ke khadak se apne hi rakt bahar.
Apne hi
baato.
हाँ. Continue.
के खड़क से अपने ही रक्त वहाँ बहा था.
We are stuck there. With our own burdens, our own big luggage, we are not able to move. We have our own mind blocks, we say, no? We are mind blocked. We are stuck, sort of a situation. That is our own problem, not somebody's problem. Apne hi problem hai wo, dusron ka nahi hai.
सैनिकों ने काट दिया पर कोई प्राच राज्य उनके रक्षा के लिए नहीं आया.
कंटिन्यू दैट. व्हाट इज दैट यू टेल मी? यू रीड समथिंग, डजंट मैटर विच एवर.
सैनिकों ने काट दिया पर कोई प्राच राज्य उनके रक्षा के लिए नहीं आया.
या व्हेन द सोल्जर्स गॉट किल्ड, कट एंड डाइड, नोबडी केम टू सपोर्ट देम और टू इवन मॉन्ट देम, बिकॉज दे ऑल गॉट सरेंडर्ड टू अलेक्जेंडर. सो एक्चुअली इट्स अ हेल्पलेस सिचुएशन, दैट्स व्हाट इट सेज. It is not winning war, but still people have something against Alexander. Everybody accepted him also. So those who were fighting against him did not even get recognition of their Veera Mrityu.
वीरों की भूमि निर्दोषों के मस्तकों से पर रही थी. अब भी पराजित जन कृतित स्वामी प्रत्यावर्तन करे भूमि पर अधिकार पाने के लिए आपस
सी द स्वामी इज द राजा. द राजास डोंट. द स्वामी. Swami always means Raja, who serves. Swami is the meaning, he is serving. So he is serving the Praja. In that kingdom, when they fail, immediately what will happen? Alexander is not going to stay there and rule the country. some other local leader who is powerful will go and use that opportunity to become king. And they are so happy, Alexander gave him a chance of becoming a king. Nobody is going, Alexander is not going to administer the whole area. Alexander wants some local person to engage himself as the leader there to control the kingdom. So whenever Alexander killed the real Swami, who is the king, immediately somebody else came and they were apas vapas. That means they individually were envious, they want the power, they took that opportunity to become the smaller king. That's a big tactic which most of the invaders do. Invaders will first buy one group of people and say that I will kill the king, you can become the king. So that the king becomes his person. Now you read again, you will understand.
Zero. वीरों की भूमि निर्दोषों के मस्तकों से पर रही थी और तब भी पराजित जर्मनों तदाकथित स्वामी प्रत्यावर्तन करे अलेक्जेंडर से भूमि पर अधिकार पाने के लिए आपस में लड़ रहे थे.
Understood? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Once it became Alexander's land, then these vidrohis, these people who are against the Swami, who were innocent kings, against the innocent kings, these cunning kings came and then started taking the position.
और यदि हमने अपने सांस्कृतिक विरासत को छोड़ा तो हमारा पतन है.
निश्चित है. वॉट इज निश्चित, वॉट इज डेफिनेट? एस्यूम वी लूज अवर कल्चर, देन अवर पथन, अवर डिफीट इज 100% श्योर. वॉट वी शुड नॉट लूज इज इंडियन कल्चर वेन वी आर इन इंडिया. दैट मीन्स एवरी वन ऑफ अस हैव सेम कल्चर, सो इन दैट कल्चर वी शुड गेट यूनाइटेड. नाउ रीड अगेन.
और यदि हमने अपने सांस्कृतिक विरासत को छोड़ा,
yeah,
तो हमारा
इफ वी लीव अवर संस्कार, संस्कार इज कल्चर, इफ वी लीव अवर कल्चर देन व्हाट विल हैपन?
आवर
डिफीट इज श्योर. सो व्हाट वी शुड नॉट लूज इज अवर कल्चर. वी कीप सेइंग नो दैट इज माय प्राइड, माय कल्चर, माय इंडिया, माय फीलिंग, दैट वी शुड नॉट लीव.
चेतना को जागृत नहीं किया गया, इस राष्ट्र को संगठित नहीं किया गया, तो इस राष्ट्र को अपने राष्ट्र को विद्रमित दासता से मुक्त करना कठिन हो जाएगा.
या इट इज डिफिकल्ट टू कीप द नेशन, संगठित करना है. व्हाट इज टू बी डन? संगठनम इज जॉइनिंग, यूनियन, बी यूनाइटेड. What is the first word? You keep
Chetna.
Chetana. What is Chetana? Chetana is the life. The Chetana is the life. The spirit of life. The Chetana is the spirit. So you keep your Chetana alive. Then next one.
चेतना को जागृत नहीं किया गया.
जागृत, जागृत इज व्हाट? जागृत इज ऑलवेज रेडी, रेडीनेस. कीप अवर स्पिरिट रेडी, देन चेतना को जागृत करना है. और देन व्हाट?
राष्ट्र को संकट नहीं किया
गया. या विद दैट स्पिरिट वी शुड मेक द नेशन यूनाइटेड. So I told you, no, the whole essence is this sentence. Don't have to unmute. You keep it, no, keep it unmute only. Don't have to mute it. So this chetana, this spirit, has to be kept in jagrat. चेतना को जागृत करके रखना है. ऐसा रखे तो क्या होता. नेक्स्ट 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 पार्ट.
इस राष्ट्र को अपने राष्ट्र को विद्रमित दासता से
या दासता. We don't have to go and surrender to them if you keep that spirit with us. Vidrohi dasata. The people who are coming for invading us, do you want to surrender to them or keep the spirit of the nation with you and that courage with you and unite the nation? What is that you want to do? That's what he is asking.
Sir, in the last part of the speech, sir, I did not get that part. Yeah, tell me again. Sir, I did not write it down because I did not understand what he said. But
will you be able to play or is it possible for you to play there now?
This is what I wrote. Ma Bharati Tumara Ma Pradesh Karega. That's
Ma Bharati. Our India will Pratisht. They will put your image. They will remember you. Where do you Pratisht? Where we have kept Mahatma Gandhi? Inside our heart. Yeah, so each one will remember you as the person who saved Ma Bharat. Every person in this country will understand that you are the person who saved us. And your position will be in everybody's heart. Ma Bharat heart means it is in everyone, individual, the citizens of India will ever remember. See, that is why still we are remembering Kaudilya, we are listening to his lecture and talking like this. Because he is the one who made that happen, right? So if that can happen, if you are responsible for doing it, it is 100% sure every citizen in this country will start remembering your contribution. Read that again, you will understand.
माँ भारती तुम्हारा मार्ग प्रदर्शित करेगा.
या माँ भारती, the whole Indian nation will start pradishtha. They will keep you inside their heart. See, yes. the beauty of learning and reading, if you understand the context, what is that message he is trying to tell you? This is the reason he is talking. This is the message he is taking. Once you know that, understanding the individual sentences will become easier for you. Because you know the context. You know why he is talking. That is more important. If you don't understand what is he telling, why he is telling, that's why study, learning is always why, what, when, how, where, with whom. You understand the scope and objective. If you know the scope and objective of that talk, then sentence by sentence you can even guess the meaning.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, he said... I do not understand the meaning of these two words, Madrich and Shudrich.
Again, repeat it.
Madrich and Shudrich.
No, that sentence I want. डिफिकल्ट अदरवाइज टू इंटरप्रेट.
वायु प्रदेश के प्रत्येक ग्राम और प्रत्येक नगर में कैके मालो मद्रक्ष सुद्रक्ष क्षत्रिय कटोसुदे युजकैन वक्त प्रत्येक गण राज्य में स्वहिन संग्राम की अग्नि के प्रज्वलन करना है और इस सर दैट इज नॉट क्लियर फॉर मी.
या व्हाट इज अंगराज्यम?
I'm not sure.
Just now I told you the head is one anga, hand is another anga. Anga means individual part of my body.
Yes, sir.
Anga bhangam means one of the part is lost. Bhangam means lost. Angam means my every body part is called angam. So anga rajyam is every part united becomes my body. So Angarajyam is Bharat, the conceptual Bharat, like my body, my Shariram. Okay, so in that Angarajyam, there are a lot of people, Yavanas, different individualistic people are there. That is the description given in the beginning. Vayu, what is that? Repeat it again from that sentence.
Yeah,
that is one Pradesh. Vayu Pradesh is some Pradesh. Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, we will say, right? So similarly, some names of those country during that time, the states, smaller portions, that is what is explained there. Vayu Pradesh.
Pratigram.
Individual gram. Gramam is individual villages. Individual places, all of them. Yeah, pratigram.
Or pratyek nagar.
Yeah, pratyek nagar. Each city, each village. He is describing that area, geography.
Yes, sir.
Now you will understand the whole thing. Correct.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, read again.
वायु प्रदेश के प्रत्येक ग्राम और प्रत्येक नगर में कैगे मालो मद्रक्ष सुद्रक्ष क्षत्रिय कटोसुधे.
या सी
लुच कैन
ईच ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल क्षत्रियास क्षत्रिया इज द वॉरियर्स एंड रक्षक पीपल सुरक्षक पीपल देर ऑल सेफ गार्डिंग पीपल आर देर. Durakshak people are there, disturbing fellows are also there. All many, many varieties of people are there. Yeah, then?
Then, sir, some of the parts are not clear.
Yeah, yeah, read. Whatever possible you read.
Lushkayan bhat pratyek gan ajya me swahin sangram ki.
Sangram ki. They have to be collected together, put them together. For what purpose? What you do is, you listen to that, you record the same thing and send it to me telling that from this time to this time is what I have recorded like this. So I will catch the pronunciation and get back to you.
Yes, sir.
It will become clear. Yeah. Don't have to be hurry. Let us...
Morning everyone. I am Ritha Thaju studying in grade 9 in Scholars Indian School, Ras Al Khaimah, UAE. Today, I'm going to be giving a speech that was delivered by Chanakya about prediction and warning about India in Hindi. Here it goes. Pradishtika rajyo mein sahasta shaurda natao kuch sovat ekta Alakshendra ke pad par raj ke vedi par apne ahangar ko samarpit nahi kiya. विज्ञान व मंत्र की मार मगड़ की रक्त से नहा उठी और कोबडियों को अपने ठोके में टुकराता अलेक्जेंद्र आगे बढ़ गया. कोई नहीं था जो उसका मार्ग रोक था. धन्य है भारत की वह पग पग भूमि जहाँ कठिन ब्राह्मण ने अलेक्जेंडर का विरोध या विद्रोह किया पर हंसते हंसते मृत्यु को स्वीकार किया। न मस्तको और शाडघो की भूमि के वीरों को जिन्होंने अलेक्जेंडर के भारत में रहते ही अलेक्जेंडर के विरुद्ध विद्रोह किया। दुर्भाग्य ही था इस धारा का भूमि के संतानों पर आक्रमण करने के लिए आक्रांताओं का साथ आम विभव और अन्य शासकों ने दिया। अपनी ही भादवों के खड़ग से अपने ही रक्त बहा था, अपने ही बाणों से अपने ही भादों की सीने चलने हुए थे, अपने ही हाथों से अपने ही घरों में आग लगाई और विजय का रक्त चिंतनीय यवनों माते पर लगा। मालोगण राज्य की भूमि शव से पट गई थी, सैनिकों ने काट दिया पर कोई प्राचराज उनके रक्षा के लिए नहीं आया। मालोगण राज्य में आत अलेक्जेंडर की कराबर हजारों स्त्री और शेषों में खेल रहे शिशुओं को हथियारों से चली कर दिया पर नियत और निर्दोषों अर्थनाद किसी को सुनाई नहीं पड़ा। ब्रह्मस्त के नगर के समस्त ब्राह्मणों और यवनों के विरुद्ध हथियार उठा लिया, अपने प्राण दे दिया पर राज के सम्मान नहीं दिया। वीरों की भूमि निर्दोषों के मस्तकों से पड़ रही थी और तब भी पराजित जनमनों तदाकथित स्वामी प्रत्यावर्तन करे अलेक्जेंडर से भूमि पर अधिकार पाने के लिए आपस में लड़ रहे थे। भय सिर्फ यवनों के दास्ता का ही नहीं है पर उस सांस्कृतिक दास्ता का भी है जो धीरे धीरे समाज में जन्म लेगी। पराजित राज तब भी तब तक पराजित नहीं होता जब तक वहां में सांस्कृतिक मोबलियों की रक्षा करवाता है। पर क्या धर्म और जाति के नाम पर घंट घंट में बढ़ाए राज आक्रांताओं से अपनी संस्कृति की रक्षा कर पाएगा? यदि आक्रांताओं को इस धरती पर शुरू होना है तो उन्हें व्यक्ति से व्यक्ति को जोड़ने वाले संस्कृति पर आक्रमण करना होगा और वे करेंगे यदि हम सावधान नहीं हुए तो। और यदि हमने अपने सांस्कृतिक विरासत को छोड़ा तो हमारा पतन निश्चित है। अनुभव कहता है कि पराजित मन, पराजित राज्य और पराजित राष्ट्र प्राय विजेता के संस्कार संस्कृति को स्वीकार करते हैं। इस राष्ट्र को संकट नहीं किया गया तो इस राष्ट्र को, अपने राष्ट्र को विधर्म दास्ता से मुक्त करना कठिन हो जाएगा। विद्या ही मुक्ति का मार्ग दिखाती है और यदि वेरेज मर्त ये व्यर्थ है, जन मरण के बंधन से मुक्ति भी चाहने वाले भारतीय यवनों का बंधन स्वीकार करेंगे। इस राष्ट्र को यवनों से मुक्त करना है और इस राष्ट्र को मुक्ति में ही तुम्हारी मुक्ति है तो इस सोए हुए समाज को जागृत करो। इस राष्ट्र में शक्ति है पर वसुक्त है, उसे जागृत करो तो उस साहस में जागृत करो जो इस समाज में है, उस सामर्थ्य को जागृत करो जो इस राष्ट्र में है। पर ध्यान रहे, स्वतंत्रता का ये यज्ञ यौवन का बलिदान मांगेगा, स्वार्थ का बलिदान मांगेगा और तो और जागृत हो रही रणछड़ी का जीवन का बलिदान मांगेगी। पर ध्यान रहे, जागृत लक्ष्य आक्रांताओं से मुक्त लक्ष्य बलिदान साध्य नहीं साधने अथवा बलिदान पौरुष रहित ना हो, व्यर्थ ना हो। धन्यवाद।
You have learned it thoroughly and you are doing a lot of homework. The idea is you got a great subject with you. You understood a great concept. You understood about Kaudilya. It is part of a big serial of things. I think 57 episodes were there. Hundreds of episodes. I prescribe to all children to look at two great knowledgeable episodes which came as TV serial. One is Chanakya. Second one is Bharat Ek Khoj. भारत एक खोज. द डिस्कवरी ऑफ इंडिया हूज बुक इज दैट?
भारत एक खोज.
या डिस्कवरी ऑफ इंडिया हूज बुक इज दैट? एनीबडी हियर?
जवाहरलाल
नेहरू's book. So Jawaharlal Nehru's Discovery of India describes Indian history includes starting from Mahabharata war and subsequently all that what happened in India. Great monuments, great temples, all of them are described. And all these descriptions are around 50 number of TV programs. Like a story, like a beautiful story. Great actors acted in that. So if you look at Bharat Ek Khoj and then say Qutub Minar, Taj Mahal, whatever you want to know in India, the Indian culture, Mahabharata, Bharat Ek Khoj, then you will get that portion of that serial and you will really enjoy. And you don't have to read the whole epic, all the Purana. Seeing that will tell you exactly the crux of the problem. It is like a description, showing the picture, taking you to that place where it happened with a nice narrative. Beautiful. That is, yeah, that is also in Hindi. So the advantage is, those who have problem with the language, if you look at Bharat Ek Khoj and Chanakya, aap logon ko Hindi itna saaf saaf ho sakte hai, aasan se samajh payenge aur baat karne ke liye bhi problem nahi hota aapko. Malum ho gaya? One of the best method to learn a language is looking at documentaries, listen to songs, listen to beautiful cinema. There is one song, beautiful song, Amitabh Bachchan's. If you have not listened, you must listen to that. Koshish karne walon ke haar nahi hota hai. Koshish karne walon ke, that's the best motivational song which is available. If you keep trying, you will never fail in life. What a great message is that? You understood? So what is required in life? The courage to, or the wisdom to? The wisdom to?
And do things.
Yeah, continue doing things. I don't know whether you have seen.
Do things.
I don't know whether you have seen Kaun Banega Crorepati program. Amitabh Bachchan was the host. During that time, he was.
Sir, I've heard about that.
Yeah,
program.
During that time, he was singing this. Laharom se tharkar nauka paar nahi hote. This is the
लहरों से डरकर नौका पार नहीं होती, कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती. नन्ही चींटी जब दाना लेकर चलती है, चढ़ती दीवारों पर 100 बार फिसलती है.
If you try to climb on top of the wall, many times the hand may fall, but still it will climb. Just because there is wave in the sea, nobody is keeping the boat beside and then not venturing to go inside the sea. They still go into sea.
Man ka vishwas ragon mein saahas bhata hai.
If you have man ka vishwas, you keep your courage in your mind, they are the people who are saahasis, courageous fellows.
Chadhkar girna, girkar chadhna, na akharta hai, aakhir uski mehnat, बेकार नहीं होती।
मेहनत बेकार नहीं होती। You will have to walk and fall and walk and fall. Because when you do that walk and fall trial, later you can run.
कोशिश करने वालों की कभी हार नहीं होती।
कोशिश करने वालों की हार कभी नहीं होती। What a beautiful song is this. See, what is to be done is, I am not a North Indian, I am not taken birth in the Hindi region. And I did not study Hindi after my 10th class. But I keep listening to these things. Probably I am not qualified to explain Rida, the meanings of Chanakya. But I understand the essence. I understand the sequence. I understand the objective. I understand the scope. From that I can interpret and then tell you. If you ask me word by word, I will fail. But I understand the essence. What is important is not word by word. What is more important is the essence.
Yes, sir.
You understood? If you know the essence,
yes,
I may tell the same speech what Chanakya is telling, but not using those words. Okay. That is how it should come to you. But at your age, you can do both. You can understand the concept. You can also learn that by heart. And if you do it now, in the whole life, you will remember this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So good initiative. I'm so happy. See, when you asked, I said, no, it's optional. Don't have to do it. Correct? But you took that in interest. I am looking for such students who want to learn. They keep going for many things. Now, how many I introduced many things. If some other people who are here, if they could pick up Amitabh Bachchan song and then explain it, maybe take Bharat Ek Khoj, one of that, and then give a narration. What happened? I studied this. That is the interest all of you should have. Good enough? Or you have something more to ask?
Yes.
Anybody else have got anything to learn? Anything to ask? Just because Rida wanted a interaction, I called her. You can come on to video if you are wanted to interact. You could ask me some questions now. Immediate. Don't wait too much and think. I will just come go off. Yeah.
Hello?
Diya.
Sir, I saw in an interview that one of your interviews that you have talked to APJ Abdul Kalam, sir.
Mm.
If you speak to a great person like him, what are the things you should know from him? What are the things?
See, I have seen much greater person than Abdul Kalam. Being president of India is not something great. It just got an opportunity because Chandrababu Naidu suggested his name. It is a political appointment. If he was not president of India, I am telling none of the Indian students like you will know him. You understood? There are a lot of people who were in different positions. Abdul Kalam was a simple man. I have a lot of admiration to him. But if you ask me whether he was a great man, he was not a great space scientist. He went to Defense Department. So whatever he learned in Space Department, he used in Defense Department. So he knew how to use his knowledge. When he was in Defense Department, he used lot of the knowledge what he has in Defense Department for medical system. Because defense needs lot of metals which are used for very specific purposes. Not rusting in different situations, different conditions. You can send in space also. When we send a metal, it should not get rusted, right? So he found that can be used when people want some bond to be replaced. You can use that metal. See, that's a great thought. Medical people will not think like this, but he used to think. So he is a great person with great thought.
But his thoughts are more important.
Yeah, that is what I'm saying. His thoughts are important, and therefore he had a lot of people who are supporting him with that great thought. You read a lot of quotes from, it is not, most of them are not even written by him. I know him personally because he cannot write that good. But he will have the thought, he will tell somebody else will help him in writing. He is a president, right? He has got hundreds of IAS people under him. He has got great, Y.S. Rajan is a great scientist from Department of Space. Y.S. Rajan is a co-author. You know most of the books. When you say APJ Abdul Kalam, below that there is another name. And Y.S. Rajan. But you are not even remembering Y.S. Rajan. So why do they write and Y.S. Rajan? Because that is written by Y.S. Rajan. If somebody writes Y.S. Rajan's book, nobody will read it. The publisher knows the trick of marketing. You understood? So don't think that the fame is what makes him great. Fame doesn't make him great. There are a lot of famous people in the country. They are not great, probably. My meditation master is not at all famous, but there are a lot of stupid sannyasis who are all famous in India. Their knowledge is zero, but they know how to market. You understood? So how do I know? Now you asked about immediately I have a poetry written on Kalam. I have a lot of respect. That's why I wrote a poetry. I don't know how many of you read. I told this in the last interaction. Kalam, the Malak. Malak means the angel. In Arabic it means ornament. I said the Malak to Kalam, the Malak. It's a beautiful book. The design is such beautiful. I'm sure you will all love to look at that book. But I'm sure you are not even initiated or interested to look at it. If you have done it, probably you will write somewhere, you will send me a message. That's how people read. So there is a book called The Rhythm of Life, in which 100 poetries are there. 55th poem is about Abdul Kalam. About Jayalalitha also I have written. If you read Jayalalitha's life history I have written there, I have studied Jayalalitha thoroughly. She was a beautiful reader. She has hundreds of books. People know that she has got plenty of saris in her custody. But her library is much bigger. No politicians in India will have such libraries. So when you meet Jayalalitha, what you should ask? You should ask about books so that they will become close to you. Only when you read about them, you can have questions to them, right? I have met Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. I was not holding his hand. He was holding my hand. 20 minutes he was holding my hand without leaving. So he is a greater person for me. He is a great knowledgeable person. And we had a dialogue. What you will ask him? Sir, what is your name? Will you ask him? How many children you have? Will you ask him? So what is the 20 minutes you can speak to Prime Minister of India? If you are thoroughly read, you understood. The other day somebody was talking about the World Economic Forum. Did they not had something to contribute? When Dia presented chess, did they not had something to ask you? Why?
Because you know about
them. I read, I understand. When you said chess is 1,000-year-old, immediately I said no. Because origin of chess is in India, you said origin of chess is Chaturangam. Chaturanga is in Mahabharat. Mahabharat is 5,148 years old. Therefore, this has to be that much old. So when somebody says, if you want to talk to him, see, I met Yeshudas, I met Tilakan, I met Murali Manohar Joshi, I was with Advani in some program, I met Umman Chandy, the Chief Minister of Kerala, I met hundreds of people like that. So to all of them, I have something to ask. Got it?
Yes.
The Indian National Congress Secretary, President is either Sonia Gandhi or Rahul Gandhi. Secretary is the next person. He was there in my house for Onam celebration. In my house in Naduvil, he came to my house. Advani and me were together in Kottayam for a program. Murali Manohar Joshi and me were visiting temples together in Delhi. Got it? Scientific secretary to Prime Minister was Abdul Kalam. There was another personal secretary to Prime Minister Manmohan Singh. Every Sunday we used to meet together. And you know Metro Man, Sridharan. Sridharan used to attend my Bhagavad Gita classes. In temple when I give lectures, he used to be there. But he is a much knowledgeable person than me. That's a different matter. Now he is teaching Bhagavad Gita to people in his native place, Palakkad. So we must know the interest of people. How do you know interest of people? Look at the interview. Amitabh Bachchan and me had a tea across the table. You look at film Dr. TPS. There is a blog in which you will see I am being interviewed by Al Jazeera TV and Amitabh Bachchan sitting in the stage. And then there was Major Ravi, who makes a lot of movies in Kerala.
Yeah.
We were all around the table. And the music man in the film from Kerala. Who is that? Oscar. Rasul Pukutti and me were together. At least 3 days we stayed together. Understood? So, when it is not one person, every person is good. That is why other day when Pallavi was making a mention about somebody, I said, you missed, S. Janaki I met, M.G. Srikumar I met, M.G. Radhakrishnan, his brother I met.
So, is knowledge the way to talk about
things? You must, when you meet a film personality, you must have sufficient knowledge in film to ask him some questions. Got it? If you don't have knowledge, then what you will ask? You will ask silly questions. That's why people don't have courage to ask. It is not language which is important. You should have the concept. And you must also must see the movies. You must also, yesterday I was talking in a international conference on education. Rida is from Abu Dhabi? No, you are in RIK. There were a lot of principals. Sharjah, Indian school principal, was making a presentation. He mentioned 2 times, Dr. T.P. Shashikumar is my virtual mentor. I only met him few minutes in Sharjah for a program. Got it? So, when we have somebody in front of you, when we have a school principal, what do I have to ask him? I should ask something about school education. So, learn different subjects so that you can be with him for some time. That is what is essential. I may not be a good chess player, but I know the rules and regulations, who are all the people there. Okay, now tell me, Vishwanathan Anand is in which grade? You said in first or second. Tell me now. It is muted.
So 15th rank.
Yeah. And Girish? His name looks like an Indian, I said. He's a Russian basically, settled in New Zealand or somewhere, right? Switzerland or New Zealand. He is 10th.
Okay.
See, I'm not reading. I read sometime, no. When you say something immediately, I know he is not first and second. That's why immediately I'm able to say no.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So read without boundary, get knowledge in every field. You understood? Mysore is a beautiful place. I have a beautiful video taken when I went to Mysore Chamundeshwari temple on the top. while coming down there was a cyclist racing our car. It was 2 years back. Visibulebat, you have Visibulebat Uppittu?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. It's all beautiful food. When I studied in Bangalore, I did a Kannada certificate course, 6 months program. So reading, writing, everything I learned in the classroom.
I also applied for it.
Yeah.
I also learned a bit of Kannada from it.
Okay, anybody else? Any question? Pallavi is there?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, Neelima.
Sir, Rishika.
Rishika, come on your video.
Yes, sir.
You can all come on video because we are only few. Only 7 people. Yeah. Yeah.
Sir, can you tell us something?
Sion, you don't want to, Neelima, don't want to show your face? Sion is there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, show your face when I say immediate action. Yeah, don't worry. It's a casual discussion. Yeah. Rishika is doing makeup.
No, sir, I switched on my video.
Yeah, it's not coming. Others are not able to see her, right?
Sir, in this, the video is not like...
Okay, tell me. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, can you tell something more about the Kargil War?
Yeah, I was one who participated in Kargil War.
Oh.
Not directly. I supplied all the maps required for them. The soldiers require maps. So my job was making maps from satellite images. So during the war, how do they know which place they have to go and stand to see that part of the Pakistan? Where they could go, where they could travel, which is the travelable area. So we have to make maps, measuring the height and then telling them this is the height, this is the place name, because most of them are like a very difficult terrain. Temperature will be July, August is the time when it is really chill, cool there.
Yeah.
It could be minus 30 to minus 50 degree, you can imagine. But once it is minus 5 or below that, it doesn't affect you because you are already in cold. You are living in ice. When you are in hot temperature going into cold, you feel cold. You are already in cold, acclimatization happens. What happens? Acclimatization. Yeah. When we go to Himalaya, I went to Kailash. So when we travel to Kailash, we stay there for 1 day, 2 days, slowly you move. Immediately you go on to top, finished. You will die there. Even otherwise, we have problems. I also had a lot of problems. My nose started bleeding. The fingertips will start bleeding. Every finger will have blood outside. So all the Navadwaras will start bleeding. So you'll have a lot of problems, health problems. Many people get collapsed. So imagine in such a situation, our soldiers are staying and then fighting war, right? That's a very difficult terrain. Terrain makes it very difficult to sustain there. And then still you have to hold your gun and then start looking, watching. The sunbite itself happens. What is sunbite? When the snow reflects, all your cheeks and eyes will start cracking. You know, SPF, when you have a cold cream purchased from your shops, you look at the descriptions given. I keep reading every detail. When something is purchased, keep reading every detail printed there. That's a great knowledge. Every item which comes on advertisement in newspaper, read the whole details. So if you read any cold cream details, you will see one terminology called SPF, sun protection factor. Normally what we use in India is less than 10%. In Gulf you will get 25%, because Gulf sun is more powerful. But when you go to Himalaya, they will use 60 and 70% SPF. Though it is cold, the sunlight reflected from the snow will crack your cheeks. That is why you will see Tibetan people have black face. They are actually whitish fellows. But if you don't apply cream for some time, it will become blackish because the blood will come out. You can see small young children when we go to Kailas and all, we can see small young children, all the cheeks are reddish with the blood, and then after that sometime it becomes blackish, a dried blood, because they don't have these creams with them. So that becomes the shape. That's why you can see the Tibetan people, Himalayan people and all that have got black face, lot of wrinkles on faces. That's because of the sunbite. So you can imagine in that situation, people stay there 3 months posting. Imagine the 3 months you have to be in that cold. Then the snow glacier will start melting. The feet will not stay. Anytime you can slide and then come down. Helicopters cannot fly there. You understood? Urine will not go out because it will become solid. And if water has to be taken, you need a matchbox first. Heat it up, then you can take water. Otherwise, it is only ice. You feel thirsty, but you don't have water. Ice is there. You will have to make it into water first by heating. So it's a very difficult terrain. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Good question. Any more questions?
Yes, sir. I have a question. I'm Rida. Sir, I'm doing a research on if plants are intelligent or not. So, yeah. Sir, what is your opinion about it?
I told you, no, I have got a beautiful tulsi in my room when I was in Delhi. It had a leaf almost the size of a hand. And generally tulsi is a plant which grows 2.5 feet, but my tulsi went up to 8 feet. Every day, because I was in a restricted place, so I cannot talk to people, public activity is not there, though I do it hidingly with some people, but there are a lot of restrictions. So most of the time in my room, and I was staying alone, and I have a big room, and generally only very few people will come to meet, so I have to spend a lot of time in reading, writing, and the rest of my good time. And it was a beautiful place. It is in Mayur Vihar. Mayur means peacock. So there were a lot of peacock around my office garden. There used to be peacock walking and all that. That and all we can see. But still there is not a great time pass. So I used to talk to my tulsi, that plant. The plant started showing wonders. I have a picture. My window was almost 6 feet. And it went up to the top of the window. Then I started putting it down. Because it's like it became a reaper sort of a thing. When it grows too high, you cannot hold that stem. Is not that powerful, I mean strong to hold. So it started growing down. So I was decorating my window with that. You can imagine one window can be decorated with one plant. That's my tulsi. When I left that room, I was deputy director. My director occupied that room because of that fanciness. I don't know how long it stayed. After that, it would have dried. So there are plants, when you go and talk to them, you go and meet them, you spend some time with them, they will give you more flowers. Right? There is a great study which is done on a papaya tree. You know what's papaya tree, right? The papaya tree is a single stem tree and a lot of leaves, like another stem there. Right? And it has got a big leaf. And in between that, you will have the papaya coming. The other leaves generally will fall one by one, one by one. The lower one will fall first and the higher one will stay. It changes its color to yellowish, the green to yellow, and then once it becomes old, it falls. That's how the papaya tree is. But there was a tree in which one of the leaf, there was a small bird nest. And I found that it was in my hometown. I kept looking at it, the bird playing there, going there. And the papaya has made to fall all the other leaves. But this leaf where the bird had a nest, it kept for a long time. Don't you think that has consciousness? that understands, oh, there is a life. So I should not disturb that life. There are trees inside the forest, which is like a reaper. If a human enters that place, the reaper will come and hit you. It understands. In Kerala, there is something called Thottavadi. I don't know what is it called in English. You touch that, immediately it folds its leaves, right? There are some leaves, when you touch it, you will start itching. God has given something great power for to protect itself, right? And do you know about Fibonacci number system?
Sir, I've heard about it.
Yeah, Fibonacci number system is the number system. Only such numbers will exist in the nature. So count the number of leaves which a coconut tree has. It will be one of the Fibonacci number system that is used for measuring beauty. If you want to measure your beauty, you have to have golden ratio. From nave to head divided by your whole height. Look at that. That will always have a golden ratio. When you look at a mirror, you like the ratio of the length to breadth in a specific dimension. Nobody makes a square mirror, right? That is because it is not that appealing. Unless you have some design onto that, they will make an oval shape there to show that it is not exactly that. Otherwise, nobody makes a square. So that ratio is what is called a golden ratio. So the nature has got a golden ratio. It exactly follows. So these are all power given by God for plants. They have consciousness. You know, the sunflower changes its direction from the east to west by morning to evening. The morning sunflower will be looking towards east. By evening, it will tilt its head and then show to west. As the sun goes, it's like an antenna open to the sun. The peepal tree has got leaves. By evening, it will become almost like tired. It will fold its leaves. So you look at leaf, you will know. Okay, another consciousness. The vastu, I am a vastu person. Who knows how to construct a house, where and temple, house to construct, where directions and all that. When we go to some place, the sun is not lighting. How do you know which place is sun? We don't have a service prism. There are three north: grid north, magnetic north, and true north. All the north we are not able to find out because sun is not lighting. I don't have a magnet, but I will look at plant around and tell you which direction is what. Because plants have got a very specific direction in which it will give fruits. You look at all the plantain trees in Kerala. The all plantain trees will have its banana coming only to south or southwest. This is what observation. So you keep observing and looking at from the nature, you will know. That means the plantain tree knows the direction, right? Yeah, now you have learned about grafting, budding. You can do this in your house. What you do is, in your house you have got maybe a hibiscus is one of the best which will easily will grow when you do budding. Different color of hibiscus you can bud together to create new different colors. There are 360 varieties of hibiscus where I did a research on that. Flower therapy, that's one of my field. When you ask questions, I will branch from something to something to something else. Now, when you have this tree or a small plant where one of the branches is growing towards north, you cut that and you will have to bud this to with some other plant where you have different branches. If the original piece which you have taken is growing towards east, if you bud to west and east, try this. It will grow faster when it is towards east. Which branch is growing what direction? Cut that and draw to that only to that branch which is in that direction. It will grow faster. It is not mine. Varahamihira, a great botanical scientist from Indian tradition. Varahamihira. You can look at the age and the time. Yada dikstan praropayet. The sloka says, yata yatha dikstan. Dik means direction. Yatha, which direction? Sthan, which direction you wanted to plant them? That side if you plant, praropayet. That is how the budding has to be done. Yata dikstan praropayet. So it understands the directions. These are all research done long, 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 long back.
So I have. So last time you told that microwaves are safe, but when I researched more on it, like I think I read somewhere that it causes like harmful substances. Is that true?
Yes. That is why there will be a prescription written there. Young children, pregnant ladies, all should not go and operate it.
Okay.
And every item cannot be put inside, right? You have some limitations. That means that radiation can affect that. You can make a microwave oven to blast also. If you put unwanted thing there, it will start creating huge energy and it will blast that. There are a lot of experiments. I did not say microwave oven is safe. It is safe for some feet.
Okay.
Beyond that feet when you go, and if you don't operate in the normal conditions, once you are closing, it is only pushing to the center from different directions. So it's not emerging out. But still around that 4 feet of radiation is there.
Okay.
Yeah. Good enough, Rida?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you. Enjoy learning. Thank you, all of you. If you don't have any questions, I will call it a day. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye. Bye.
Thank you so much, sir.
Bye. Bye. Bye.